What's up, guys? Good morning, good morning, good morning. Got some seaweed. Got a haircut. Look at that. All short, squared up. How we doing, guys? Good morning. Milton Todd. We got some annoying seaweed floating around, but you know what? Let's see what happens. Morning, Bud Files. Morning, Brandon, buddy. What's up, Buggy? Dan, what's up, pal? What is up? I got some other stuff I'm gonna mix up if this stuff doesn't work, so. Nice fresh bowl to mix some bait in. But we're gonna give this stuff a whirl. Look at this. Some panko, some corn, and some white hominy. We're gonna try that out if what I have doesn't work. But let's see what's up. What's up, Sid? How you doing, buddy? Got some seaweed out there. It's already on that one rod. It's kind of annoying. You know, it'll be nice if that left rod, that white rod, gets hit today. How's everybody doing today? All right? Everybody having a good day? We turn the car off. And the heat is blowing right out of the pipes. Got some cornmeal. I got all sorts of stuff I could use today. But we'll see how it goes. I think there's a sunny or something messing with that right rod. I see it flinching a little bit. That ain't a carp. I'll tell you that. That ain't a carp. Carp will just take it and run. What do you guys think? How's my haircut look? All short. I'm like a different person without all this hair on my head. All right, no sunnies. Let's go. Just some nice sized carp. Let's do that. Watch out, cornmeal. You're in my way. No sunnies. We don't want no sunnies today. No sunnies pecking around. Man, that'll be cool if that white rod gets hit. That'll be cool. That ain't seaweed on my line, so that was a little pecking around going on. Yeah, we do, Sid. And they're in here, buddy. Tell you that. It is a beautiful day. Cloudy. It's supposed to be like 80 degrees. Yeah. I don't know if you can see that right hit indicator. No, you can't see it. But it's flinching up a little bit, and that ain't a carp. It's probably a sunny or even a trout. And you never know, it could be a catfish too. Yeah, something's definitely pecking at it. That's not what I'm going for. Yo, Chris, what up, pal? How you doing, buddy? How you doing, bud? Yeah, something small messing with that. It's probably on the line. Still flinching a little bit. It's probably a little sunny or something. Wait for them lines to run. That's what we want. That's what we want, guys. That is what we want today. How you doing, Ryan Smith? I went to the bar to have a beer after dinner last night, and the bartender was more messed up. Jeez. Idiots. Yep. Let's go. Let's do this. When I first pulled in here, I don't know, 20 minutes ago, I was getting all set up. I saw a nice, nice sized carp roll on the top of the water, maybe about 15 feet out. Thanks, Chris. I need it, buddy. I need it. Yeah, bartenders shouldn't be allowed to drink. That should be a law, my friend. A little sunny or something messing around that right rod. Don't need that. Let's get some fish today, guys. I got corn and strawberry pack bait on those two rods straight ahead. And I got strawberry pack bait on the left rod with a nickel size corn boilie.
See that hit right there? That was something small. Something small, but it was a hit.
Not a car.
Well, I don't want the sun to be protecting on this, so. I got four white kernels on that hook.
Oh, good. The pack bait fell. That's a good thing. The pack bait I made comes off nice, so that's a good thing. I need it all gluey and stuck to the method feeder. Let's get some fish, Dan. Daz, what's up, buddy? I got no hat on. I got a haircut, man. I got a haircut. Got a haircut. Let's go, fish. Everybody doing today? Good? Everybody doing all right? keep everybody hanging in there at least. I'll be doing better if I catch a fish. Yeah, what's up, Seraphim? How you doing, buddy? When I got here, I saw a nice carp roll about 15 feet in front of me. So my fingers are crossed. Fingers are crossed. How you doing, Damien? What's up, pal? Morning, good morning, good morning. I never caught a carp on that white rod that's sticking up over there. So that'd be pretty cool. That'd be pretty cool. We need some lines to start spinning. Lines start spinning. I have faith in this spot. That's why I'm back here. Got some faith today. Faith, fish, and fresh haircut. Yep. I made the pack bait just right today. Disintegrates. It comes right off the method feeder, which is what I want. I don't want that sticking like glue stuck to it, you know? Don't work like that. I'm gonna mix up some other stuff, right, Ryan Smith? What's up, Carbon Catfish? I tell you, man, the weather is good here. I saw a nice carp roll as soon as I got here about 20 minutes ago. So I'm hoping. I am hoping. I got my ground bait. Oh, look at that. Spilled some on the ground, chipmunks. I got my ground bait here, my pack bait. And I am doing. Some white hominy, some corn, and some panko. And some little bit of cornmeal. So, we'll see. We will see what happens, guys. I do have a good feeling about today. It might not be in 3 minutes, but I got a good feeling about today. Hey, Daryl, what up, buddy? What's up, pal? How you doing, Leon? Good morning, good morning, and good morning. Let's get some fish today, huh? Get some fish today, hey? One of them rods we're gonna go. I'm telling you. We're gonna get some fish today. I'm telling you. I am telling you. Telling you, telling you. No, it's not a dog ball, but it looks like one, don't it? I actually got a set of those balls, different sizes. Fish. I'm gonna throw a couple stuff out there. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Watch, now that I'm mixing all this stuff up, my hands are going to be disgusting. And a fish is going to take one of them lines. Sir Dirty Cuss, what's up? How you doing, pal? Good to see you. Let's Today's a good day. It ain't sunny. You know, the sun wants to come through, but it ain't. And it ain't too hot, so let's get some fish. Let's get some fish. Oh, no. What? It's not a carp that's hitting that corn on that right rod. I saw that friggin' thing flinch again. Come on, I don't want no sunnies today. I don't mind waiting a little while to get a decent carp, but I don't want to keep reeling in because the sunnies are hitting. You always get them little fish that want to peck at that mixture. Alright. Got this mix going. Let's try a couple little different things today. You'll get them, dirty cuss. You'll get them, buddy. Just keep on trying like I am, man. That's all you could do. Just keep on going at it, you know? Throw a couple meatballs out there. Throw a couple meatballs out there. Get these suckers over here, huh? Come on, guys. Come on. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. One of them lines is gonna go. Just throw some corn on there, Dan. Just wait, buddy, like me. Keep on waiting. It's a waiting game with these carp, I tell you. Two different pack baits going on here. I only got one out right now. So. Give it a whirl, huh? Give it a whirl with the other one if this one don't work. I got Goya cans. I got everything here. My own fish. Come on. I saw a nice carp when I first got here. Suckers are here. They're here. I hear you, sir. I hear you. Carp fishing's a blast when you're catching them. You gotta have a lot of patience, you know, if they're running slow like they have been for me. But good morning, California. How are you? How we doing today? How's the camera set up? All right. All right. Looks good. Connection's good. Should be pretty clear. Should be pretty clear. I've had them two rods out there for 20 minutes. Usually give it about a half hour before I change things up. All right. Come on. One of them hit indicators are going to sling right up and one of them lines are going to go, man. Let's get him, Daz. Let's catch him up today, right? Good morning, buddy. Got two different pack baits. Two different ones here. So I got this one out right now. So we're going to try this one. in a little bit, you know? Mix it all up. And if they don't hit anything, I don't know what's to tell you. Yo, what up, Billy? Guten Tag. Good morning. Willie. What's up? What's up, pal? Bearded Eagle. What's up, buddy? I do have a... I'm telling you, I got some faith in today. The weather's perfect. Got some seaweed in that water, but... That's all right. What's up, buddy? What's up? Oh, man, I'd love to see that. That white rod, I'd love to see that thing get slammed and go down. Never caught a carp on that. I got 20-pound tests on everything, in case anybody's wondering. Mono, mainline, 20-pound, and I got fluorocarbon leader, 20-pound. I'm using a boilie, a corn boilie, on that left white rod, and I got corn on them two middle rods. I got my pack bait going on, the method feeder, so... See how it goes. See how it goes, guys. Leaf Lay, what's up? How you doing? Does anybody have a... See if I can find them in this mess that I got here. Anybody have any use for these things? Anybody have any use for these? They're 2 ounce jigs. Anybody have any use for those? I got like 2 or 3 of them. Use them for bouncing for fluke in the ocean. A good question. I like the flat ones that you pack the bait around, and I also got one of them cone style ones. But the problem with that is if you put, you know, your boilie or you put your hook on that, there's a chance that it can get tangled up in that wire. What's up, Yak Shore? Yo, what's up, buddy? The fish, they're gonna be here today. I got a feeling about today. I got a feeling. I seen a nice one roll as soon as I got here. Doesn't mean I'm going to catch him, but I seen one. What's up, barbecue? How you doing, buddy? How we doing? How we doing, everybody? I don't even know which, I couldn't even tell you by name which one they are, Brandon. I got a handful of different ones. I'll show you. I got all different ones on all three rods. When I reel them in and recast and rebait up, I'll show you the three that I got that I'm using. Good morning, Richard. What's up, buddy? What's up, Buck? Yeah, man. I know those Buck Williams. They look like bullets. They look like those footballs you used to throw around. They used to make the whistling noise when you throw it. You cast it out and it opens up something small messing with that right rod. Something tiny. Could be catfish. I've gotten bullheads on this stuff. Yeah, they gotta start hooking up, Dan. You gotta start hooking up. I got good stuff on here. Come on, guys. I gotta do a giveaway. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna do a giveaway for something. I got so much stuff that I never used, you know, unopened. Different things. I have no use for them. Hey, Billy, would you have any use for these suckers? They're 2 ounce with the round head, with the eyes. They're 2 ounce jigs. I can't even see the hook. It's packed up so tight there, and I don't want to open the bag. But I know you fish the ocean a lot. I don't know. You have any use for these? I have a couple of them. They're 2 ounce. Yeah, do whatever you want, Darren. It's all good, buddy. Is it a sweatshirt or a t-shirt? I forget. Daz, I forget. You're good? All right, I was just going to send them to you if you needed them. Or if you could use them. I got no use for them. I'm sure I can take them apart and figure out something like that. Barbecue. Buck. Look at this. All short. All smooth. Man, it's... It's nice. It's nice to get a haircut. I haven't had a haircut since December. Yeah, I don't remember. Daz, honestly, I don't remember. I'd have to go back to that live and check it out. I don't remember. Send me anything, buddy. Yeah, Anthony, I hear you. One day I'll have no hair. Hopefully not, but... All right. That's it. All right, we're going to... Been a half hour. We're gonna change things up. Change these two up. Oh, it just fell, huh? Come on, Clark. I know you're here. Brandon, if you're still watching, this is the one I got on here. And I got the a corn boilie on here. I got chicken liver boilies, too, I could throw out. Maybe catch a catfish, but that's what I got on this rod. Pack the bait right on here. And then call it a day, you know? Let's go, Lines. Let's go. Come on, Lines. Let's go, Lines. Absolutely, Anthony. If I'm fishing tomorrow, of course, buddy. You know that. I don't care if anybody hops on here. I don't care at all. If anybody's fishing right now and wants to hop on, be my guest. Oh, Daz. Looks like your head now. Looks like you. right, let's try. Let's try this bait. Let's try this one out. Or sling right off when I cast it, but it's all right, it's all right. There we go. There we
Seaweed
looks no good. Here's the other one, Brandon. I'll show you the third one too. It's the other one I got. Just a little one. Pack the bait right around there. You could put the hook in. You could take it. You could pack the bait around here. And you could, you know, put your hook in there with the bait and just pack it all around so when it dissolves, this is in the middle. This is a good one to do that for. See that fish? That was a carp that just jumped right there. That was a carp. So they're here. They are here. They're not on my line, but they're here. I didn't see what you said, Dan. I got to check it in a second, buddy. Sounds pretty stupid to me. What's up, Anthony? How you doing? Hey, I'm trying, buddy. I am trying. I seen a couple carp surface today, so. Suckers are, they're here. They are here.
Just because they've been a couple jumps right here doesn't mean they're right here. Anyway,
Brandon, here's the other one I'm using. This is the other method feeder I got on here. The little, you got a little tiny black piece that stays on here. So the carp could take the line for, I don't know, a foot or however far apart you have this designed. And it'll just, no, they won't feel mine. Let's get this guy out there again. Let's get this guy out there again, huh? But I think I saw Barbecue say something before. Yes, plain corn. Plain corn is what I got on two of them, buddy. Plain corn is what I got on two of them. So. Just get this out there. I'll catch up with chat. What's up, Nitro? If anybody's fishing and wants to pop up here, be my guest. Just let me know. And I'll drop the link. I'm using very small hooks on two of the rods, so. Let's go, let's go, let's go. We need a runner. We need a runner. What's up, Jeremy? What up, buddy? Triple R, what's up? Danny Stone, what's up, pal? I got a couple different baits that I'm using here, so. Most of it is corn. Most of it is corn. So a couple nice fish. The first one I saw surface was a nice fish. The second one, I don't know how big it was, but I saw the gold. So I know it's carp. So I got that left rod pretty close. I got that right rod kind of close. And I got that middle rod pretty far out there. Don't catch that seaweed. Feels like today's going to be a good day. You know, I have that day every day. I feel like I'm going to catch fish. But today feels like one of them days that could be good. The weather's nice. So. See what happens. We'll see what happens. Let's go fish. Let's go fish. Let's go. Let's go. When you want, just go. I don't care. Take that white rod right into the water. I'll go jumping right in it. Jumping right in it. I hear you, JBT. You have those days, man. I was tired yesterday. I didn't feel like going fishing. But today, cloudy. I mean, the sun's trying to break through. Break it through a little bit. But it's supposed to be cloudy most of the day, all day. I think a chance of showers later. But it ain't that hot. It's a little muggy, but it really ain't that hot. It's supposed to be like it's supposed to be hot next week. Hey, what's up, Indiana buddy? What's up, pal? bring some luck. I've seen some carp surface, but nothing so far. Just waiting for, you know, just waiting for one of them lines to go, man. That's all. Just waiting for one of them lines to go. 108? That's terrible. That is way too hot for anything outside. I don't want that sun to come out. I don't think the fish want the sun to come out either. Let's do it, fish. Let's do it. Why are there little... I'm telling you, I'm getting little tiny taps on that right rod. They're little sunnies or something. They keep... It's just the right rod. It's all it's doing it to. We don't want that. We want the line just to go. Just go. Too nice of a day to not catch fish. No, Danny, I got it. I got that other rod here. You know what I got on it. I think I just have a regular hook on it. I was plucking out them sunnies the other day on a little piece of worm. Morning, Joe Ziegler. How you doing, pal? My own fish. My own fish. Everything good? The stream nice and clear? All that stuff? Howdy, 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 everybody. Howdy, howdy. Where are you, fish? Where are you? Where you at? Where you at, fish? Float some bread out there? It's not bad. Not a bad idea. I wish I had some bread in here. I don't have any bread in here, man. I don't have any bread in here. All right, good. I'm glad everything's clear. Glad everything's clear. Now we just need some fish on the video, huh? We need some fish on the video. Well, that's a good thing if they use sunnies as food finders, because there's sunnies that are pecking around over here. So hopefully some nice carp come rolling in. I saw a couple of them roll on the surface today. Not many, but more than I've seen in the last couple days. We're gonna get something. We're gonna catch something today. All right, good. Good, good, good. Thanks, Ziegler. Thank you, buddy. Well, that will be JBT. That's the right rod. So we'll see. We will see. All right, son. Go back in. We don't need you. It's go, let's go, let's go. This is a good piece to put on there, actually. Mm-hmm. It's a good one. So every half hour, I'm going to recast, unless I get little pecks, and I think maybe the bait could be off the hook, and I'll have to recheck it. But I give it 30 minutes before I recast the rods, usually. Where are you, fish? Where are you? It's all right. It's only been 45 minutes. Got plenty of time. Started a little earlier today than normally, so I'll do a 20-hour live today. Got to catch something. That felt good. It felt good on my knee. Let's go. Buck, I have, I got blood, liver, boilies. Right now I got the corn boilie on the left rod, that white rod. But, you never know. You never know. I think, what could I toss on a fourth rod that I have here? What could I toss on a fourth rod? I don't know. If I can't catch a fish on three rods, then there's a problem. JBT, I do have a Facebook for my channel, but it's small, and I started it when I first started the channel. I really haven't done anything to it since, to be quite honest with you. But I also have my personal one, too. I'm sure somebody has it. Let's go, let's go. Come on, guys. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Time to eat. It's time to feed. Yeah, I don't mind, buddy. I don't mind. Come on. It is perfect. Perfect out here right now. It's almost too good. It's one of those days where it's almost too perfect. What's up, Cody? 3+1. What's up, buddy? Waiting on some fish, man. Waiting on some fish. Seen a couple surface, seen a couple roll, but no takers. Today's, I have a feeling about today. I'm telling you, I'll go 6 hours to catch a fish today. What's up, Randall Rhino? How you doing, buddy? Hey, Mick. What's up, pal? How you doing over there across the ocean? Everything good? Bumping Mike, what's up? How you doing, buddy? We're going to get some action today. Nice and quiet. It's dead over here. dead out here. So let's go, fish. Start feeding. Time to eat. Buggy, it's funny. Yep. Oh man, Joe, I'm sorry to hear that, buddy. Hope everybody's all right. Hopefully you're negative, pal. Yeah, I hear you. I've never had a problem using stuff like this. But I also, you know, growing up as a kid, I would just use an egg sinker. A slip sinker, cast out there, no pack bait, nothing like that, just a couple kernels. And I used to, you know, when I used to mess around for carp when I was young, and I used to pull them in, just a simple old one egg sinker with a couple corn kernels, and that always worked. Always worked, you know. Yep, hopefully all is good, pal. You never know with that stuff anyway. If it really works, you know, who knows with that. I know a lot of people who are vaccinated that still ended up getting it. So I really couldn't tell you much about that. Come on, come on. We need some movement. We need some movement, guys. Come on, geese. Bring some carp over here with you. What's up, Mr. Squirrels Magnet? How you doing, pal? Just waiting on some fish. Waiting on some fish. Oh man, kidney stones? Ugh. I'm eating a piece of chicken, if anybody's wondering. Anthony, I threw some corn out yesterday morning. I threw some corn out this morning. And then I waited about 3 hours today. Morning, Mr. Ernie. Morning, buddy. Morning, everybody. If I missed anybody, I'm trying to keep up. Come on, fish. Where are you? Where the heck are you? I'm eating all this chicken here. Oh, man. I hope it ain't too bad, Cody. I never had a kidney stone. I don't plan on having any kidney stones. Danny Stone, how about you? Any kidney stones, Danny Stone? Was it really, Chris? Are you kidding, or was it really? Because I had no idea if that was really the case. Ernie, I got a haircut, buddy. I got a haircut yesterday. Look at this. How short this is. Oh, thank God. Just Danny Stones, right? Yeah, I heard that, Anthony. Couldn't imagine. Come on, fish, where are you? The recast again, huh? Look at that. Yep, half hour. It was a half hour already. A half hour since I recasted. Triple R, you have a good day, pal. Be safe, buddy. Thanks, Cody, pal. Yeah, everybody feel free to hit the like button. Feel free. All right. Guys, a lot of bait floating around out there on that bottom. So, let's do this. Guys, I know you're in here. What are you doing? What are you doing to me? Same thing you've been doing for the last month. Fresh baits, let's go. What's up, Mr. Mike Irvin? How you doing, buddy? How we doing? Sun's out now?
Good.
Cooking my head now that I got a hair cut? I never heard of it either, Ernie. Imagine that. Oh, yeah? This one. All right. Well, that guy sees some carp from the bridge, so. Ernie, you can go live, buddy. You know that. Perfect day for fishing, guys. Perfect day for fishing. We got tractor trailers slamming across this bridge here. Perfect day for fishing. So let's get some fish, huh? Thanks for tuning in, everybody. I appreciate it. Been trying to get us on some fish for a while now. So, we'll see what happens. Come on, fish. Let's go. Come on now. Ooh, come on, fish. I know you're here. That guy just told me he sees some from the bridge. I ain't that far from the bridge, but I also can't get over there either. Huh. Up some more stuff here. come on. That guy, he's like, you're in the right spot. Yeah, well, I'm in the right spot and ain't nothing happening. Sir, the only way you're going to get it is to keep on fishing, buddy. That's what I'm doing. I couldn't tell you my personal best. It's in the 20s, but I couldn't tell you exactly what it is. Hey, Richard, yesterday morning I came here and I threw 4 cans of corn out. And this morning I came here and I threw 3 cans of corn out. And then I came back about, I don't know, 2 hours after I did that today. Daryl, I heard. I didn't see the pike, but I heard. Wish I had some extra large shiners pulling a 38 inch pike, but I'm all carp fishing right now. seems, yeah, Richard, you know, I don't know the depths over here. I don't know how deep it is in this river over here. I just know it's a river, so they keep on moving. You know, if I went to Pompton Lake and I chummed for a couple days, maybe I'd have some luck over there at the lake, because it's, you know, it's still water. What up, Brian B? What's up, buddy? Come on, Jeremy, we need some fish. This has been brutal. This has been brutal. This was my third time fishing this spot. I caught a carp 5 minutes into fishing in my first video. That was it. But the weather seems, I don't know, the weather seems pretty good today. You never know. Some water to this here. Dry. Everybody having a good day today? Everybody having a decent day, at least. It's a beautiful day here. Trying to get some fish. You know how it is, trying to get some fish. Need one of them lines to peel, huh? Thanks, guys, for tuning in. I appreciate it. I'm going to be out here for a little while. I'm going to be out here for a while today. These fish got to hit at some point. They got to be eaten at some point. I heard something splash. I didn't see it, but I heard it. Feel free to hit that like button, even if you don't like it. Maria, how are you? Thanks for stopping in. Probably, Danny. That was a big old crap, if that's what that was. All right, I got the texture right on this, I think. I'm assuming that water pill is blood pressure medicine, Ernie, right? What's up, guy? How you doing, buddy? Waiting for some fish. That's what I'm doing. Waiting for some fish. Wait for a 36 pounder. Wait for a 12 pounder. Waiting for any pounder. Quarter pound. Quarter pounder with cheese. What's up, Big Slim? Thanks, Maria. I appreciate it. I appreciate that. It's time to start catching, right? Where are you, fish? Where are you? I'm doing everything that I can think of. Besides fishing top water with bread. I could throw a lure. I could throw a lure on this ugly stick. See if I can pluck something in. Got plenty of bass lures here. Plenty of them. When do you lines go? Mom fish, let's go, let's go, let's go. How you doing, Tasha? Good morning, good afternoon. What the heck should I toss on here, huh? Should I toss on here while I'm waiting? Spinnerbait? Spinnerbait. Let's see. Let's do that. Let's do that. Let's try this. While I'm waiting for carp, let's try this out. Let's see how many weeds I can catch with this sucker. If I can get it out of the case. Come on, rods. Come on, rods. Come on. cardinal landed. Well, the cardinal almost landed right on my foot. I don't know if I like where I casted those, to be quite honest with you. I may have to do a redo on them. I may have to do a redo. All right. You know, let me, before I cast a spinnerbait out there, let me redo a couple things. These weeds get sucked right down into my line. That's the problem with seaweed. Good thing I checked this because this is all mangled. Drop some power bait on one of them rods, but I'm not gonna. Get some fresh bait out there. Big blob. Here comes the sun to burn my scalp. Man, that sun is hot. Oh, look, all of a sudden the reel doesn't make any clicking sounds anymore. Magic. Thing here. Can't catch fish when your hook's wedged in there. There's seaweed attached to it. That's the problem. What's the problemo? What's up, Cardinal? You bring me some luck, bird? right. Nothing yet, buddy. Look at this thing. Big old wad. Go cornmeal, Mr. Cornmeal. Fish, come on, let's go. I'm gonna throw a spinnerbait and see how many seaweed, how much seaweed I can catch. Let's see how much seaweed I can catch. First catch of seaweed.
Come on, Carp, let's go. Don't give me this nonsense today. I'm not up for it today. You guys are wondering, all I got is corn on them rods. My cornmeal pack meat and corn, so. One more cast over here. That I'm gonna and wait with you guys.
Oh man, still got another 30 hours to catch fish, so I'm fishing till Saturday. Takes me that long to catch a fish, I'm fishing till Saturday. What's up, Gaza? Yo, what up, Riverman? No fish. Hopefully you brought some fish with you. I seen a couple roll, but that's it, man. What's up, buddy? What's up, J-Dog? What's going on, pal? How we doing? Same old nonsense right now here. No, I'm not camping. I'm just kidding. I'm just hanging out. Hanging out waiting. The waiting game. I'm playing the waiting game. Anybody else want to play? You're right about that, Billy. It's only in the 70s here today. When that sun comes out, man, it's beating down. I wish I had dog biscuits. Wish I had dog biscuits to try. I got some at home. Of course, I don't have them here. It's all right. We're going to get some. I don't care if it's 4 hours in. We're going to catch something. Yeah, Billy, believe it or not, I did read that like dry dog food and dog biscuits work. Bizarre. Anything counts, buddy. Anything counts. I'll cast that spinnerbait out in a couple minutes again. Because there are big pike in here. And there's big largemouth bass in here. Problem is there's a lot of freaking weeds to be reeling in spinners. Oh, Stan, there you are. Zero, zero, zero. Zero, 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 buddy. How's everything going? I haven't seen you in a while. Stan, you're an idiot. You heard me. Zero, buddy. Zero, zero, zero. You know, just wait. One day you'll come in here and you'll ask that, and I'll say the fish count's 15 or 7 or 9 or 3. Turd biscuit. Stan, you're a turd biscuit. Good. A little bit of a breeze now. Good. Start moving, fish. Start moving. I got like 8 cans of corn out there. What's up, Belt Loop? How you doing, buddy? Yeah, it's smooth out here. It's a slow-moving river. Seto. I said Seto. Stan. Zilch. Because this river moves so slow. Yeah, I probably should have chummed the lake a couple days, which is what I'm going to do next. Zilch. I didn't go fishing yesterday. Yeah, this water moves so slow over here. It's called the RAMAPO River, but it doesn't move much. Welcome back, Mr. Danny. There's a guy bass fishing in his kayak right there. What's he throwing. He's got a spinnerbait on there. Look at that. He's flicking a spinnerbait as well. He's got one. Look at him. He's got one on a spinnerbait. Look at that. You guys can see that? Look at him. He got a little bass. A little largemouth on the spinnerbait. Can you see the kayak or no? Yeah, you can see him out there. Amy, good morning. How are you? Doing good. Hope you're doing good. Hope everybody's doing good. That guy flicked a spinnerbait right underneath them trees over there. And he pulled in a bass. Different bait. I got different bait. I've been using strawberry corn for a while. Now I'm just using plain corn. What a different pack bait that I made. More plain than the fruity, you know, fruity flavors. Throw some garlic knots on there. Probably would work, honestly. I probably should throw a garlic ball on there, huh? Throw a big cast net out there.
Buddy.
Maybe I should order a dozen garlic knots and try them out for me. Right, Stan? What's the fish count, Stan? That was the biggest fish I ever caught, was that kayak. Biggest fish ever, River Boys. Try something. Try something. I'm cast towards the bridge. Change the rod holders around a little bit. I'm gonna cast to the right. Can't be any worse than right where I'm fishing. Be any worse than where I'm fishing, right? Oh, Danny. I'm gonna get, if that sun stays out, My scalp's going to be burning tonight. No, I'm just busy. I'm busy, river rat. Busy. I'm supposed to read your messages when I'm casting a spinnerbait. No good. Yeah, I'm gonna burn. You're right, Danny Stone. I'm gonna sizzle out here. Got horse flies flying into my neck. Now I got a nice knot. It's nice. It's always good. Come on, really? Get a break. Give me a break. Hey, what's up, hog buddy? All right, wind. Hit the road, wind. Man, I'm boiling. I'm starting to sizzle out here. that. There with that.
I don't know. Looks like I'm going to be fishing back at the lake pretty soon. Where I started out catching all them fish. This place is just not cutting it. Not cutting it. What's up, Mr. Parker? How you doing, Johnny? Thanks for tuning in, pal. Don't ask me what the fish count is because I haven't started counting yet. Ha ha! Skull Rush, what's up, buddy? What's up, CVA? How's everybody doing, all right? Bologna. Bologna. Hi, Ernie.
How's the view? Can you see all three rods?
Let me make sure you see all three rods. Yeah, it's okay. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good. It'd be better if one of them rods went. But, no. Man, I can't fish worth a lick, Johnny Parker. How you doing, Melissa? How's the weather down there in the south, guys? All right, now I'm here. All right, River Boys, now you can talk all the smack you want. I'm here to read it. These fish ain't here worth a lick. Yeah, I hear you, CVA. I had that for a while, too. Yeah, I can fish. I know what I'm doing. I just can't catch fish. Just can't catch them. I'll do that for you, buddy. Not a problem. Yeah, he went a little short, Stan. A little short on my haircut. Yeah, I'll join you, River Boys, on Wednesday. I'll count them fish for you. Man, it's too nice out here to not catch fish. Just want that sun to go in, man. You know, they say cloudy all day, and then all of a sudden it's blue sky, and the sun's beaming down on my head. The fish can't bite worth a lick, man. What's going on here? What is going on here? Let's go now, fish. Let's go now, fish. You mean to tell me there ain't one fish swimming around that wants to suck in a corn kernel? Give me a break. I'm sure it is, Hog. I can't live where it's 100 degrees all the time. Forget it.
Yeah, river man, I'll count them fish up for you, no problem. You know that. There you go, Stan. That's a good thing. You could bring her out, you know, go, you guys can go fishing. She can catch all the fish for you. And you could hold them up. That'll work, right? Yeah, I don't think you've seen me catch a carp. You know, I caught one here. That's it. It's my third time fishing this spot. I caught one carp 5 minutes into fishing. I'll be going back to that lake. Screw it. Back to the lake. Can't be any worse than this. I need a water bottle. I'm parched. I am parchment paper. Yep, I'm out here trying, all right. Dying, trying. I don't know. I don't really know anybody else from that area, to be honest with you. Yo, what's up, barbecue buddy? What's up, chef? I'm trying to catch you a carp that you could cook up. Oh, wow. I don't know what that was that jumped out there, but it was big. It was big. For some reason, I think it was a bass or a pike. I don't think that was a carp. I'll take 90 casts over there with spinnerbait. Nothing will happen. The shroom cut. Everybody get their haircut like me. Come on. Look, I'm gonna go take more casts with the spinnerbait. Take more casts with the spinnerbait and ain't gonna catch a fish worth a lick. Eh? What that haircut stand? Gonna be all sunburned when I get home. Oh God, the sun. Oh, are you kidding me? I just had a hit.
Thank you. Oh, popped off.
As I was trying to pull him out of the water, it was a largemouth. It was a largemouth. He's probably like a pound and a half. And he hit it right at 10 feet off the bank. Right in the seaweeds. He was probably like a pound and a half largemouth.
That felt good.
Carp are inexistent.
Inexistent. cast these carp rods.
That too. I saw you come out of the weeds. Oh, it's hot out here.
Birds. You guys are leaving
a pack of the pack bait I got on here. Alright guys, I had a little largemouth on there, but he popped off. No, no carp. I had a bass on. Instead of just going down there and grabbing them, I tried to lift them. It was only like a pound and a half on the spinnerbait. Tight over here to fish. Bucko. Yeah, this is all twisted up. That ain't gonna work. That ain't gonna work. I had better luck throwing that spinnerbait out there. No, there was one time I was fishing. the Monksville Reservoir. And I was using a spinnerbait. I don't know, I was young. And I'm reeling it in, slow. And I see this muskie. It was all of 4 foot, easy. It came up, spinnerbait, I'm reeling my spinnerbait in, it came up behind it, bit my spinnerbait, and just swam away. Because I didn't have a metal leader. I wasn't fishing for muskie. Just came up, and then it just swam away with a spinnerbait in its mouth. No tug, no nothing, because it was teeth, this is nice. Nice here. I don't know how this stuff happens underwater. I really don't. Got it. Yep, I got it. All right. A little windy. Hang tight, guys. Going on here. Not even touched.
It's not working.
That's not working. 2.5 hours already of nothing? That's good. Should have just lipped that largemouth bass, huh? Just to get rid of the skunk today.
Fish are dead to me. That's it.
Fish are dead to me, guys. Don't know what the heck is happening, but Let's see if a miracle could happen, huh? See if a miracle happens on these three rods. If not, I'm going back to Pompton Lake. I'm gonna go chum after this, after I catch nothing. I'm gonna throw some corn in there. And tomorrow morning, I'm gonna throw some corn in there. I'm gonna probably go back tomorrow at like 11 o'clock in the morning and fish. Back to where I've actually caught fish. One fish out of here don't count. Bass right there that keeps on hitting me. Probably the one that I had earlier.
How's everybody doing? Good?
my hair short now. If I keep carp fishing here, I'm going to have no hair pretty soon.
Tomorrow, Pompton Lake it is. All right, you ain't going there? Good. Still fishing for a little while. I'm watching the rods do nothing. But I'm going to the lake. I'm going to start going to the lake again. I'm going to chum after this today. I'm going to start going to the lake because this is just slow. See that? I just see it way out there to the left. Something just jumped out there. Probably bass. Probably bass. So what that was? It's like watching paint dry, isn't it? You know what? I was about an hour and a half into fishing. I was thinking about taking a trip to the lake and taking everybody with me. I don't know. Looks nice. That was a... That wasn't a carp hit. But that was something that just hit that middle rod. It was probably a turtle. I don't feel like catching any turtles. Can't beat Wendy's. Let me just sling it a couple more times. Why not?
they're everywhere. Every body of water around here. Crunching around over there, bear. Trying to cast around trees. Some is killing. Thank you. ice cream man. The Ice Cream Man? Remember that movie? Done spinnering. No more spinner baiting today. I did catch one bass on it though. I didn't land it, so I can't count it.
There's no carp in here. There's no carp in here. There are fake fish jumping. Probably somebody in the woods throwing rocks, trying to trick me. Yep. another crapshoot of carp fishing. Phone charger is only at 7%. Still probably another hour or two out of that phone charger, but oh man, what a shame. What a shame it's been. I know that corn is still on that hook too, so there's no sense of reeling it in 48 times. Danny Stone, you might as well just leave. I did have a largemouth bass on the spinner bait that I was using. It's probably about a pound and a half, but I tried to lift it instead of just going down there patiently and just grabbing it by the mouth normally. I got too excited. It was the first fish in 10 years. So I tried to lift it and it popped right off. Mm-hmm. Another crapshoot of crap fishing. Alright, what are you gonna do? You know where I'll be tomorrow? Fishing again. I'm going to the lake. Back where I was 2 weeks ago. I don't know, Buggy. Right now, yeah, the sun ain't out right now. But yeah, there's places to fish under the bridge. You know, I got plenty of places to go. The problem is, you know, videoing, you know, I can get the places and I can fish. I can go under that bridge and I could flick rooster tails and this and that, and, you know, eventually catch something, but I can't get a video of it. I can't get the live stream going on it. There's nowhere to really, video. Wapapello. That sounds like something Susquehanna Stan would know. Thanks, Danny. Appreciate it, buddy. What's up, Mike? How you doing, buddy? Yeah, I know that. I haven't given up. I just, it's, you know, it's tough. It's tough when the fish ain't hitting. Yeah, there's fish. I'm sure there is fish here, Buggy. Get over here. Drive over here, would you? Show me how it's done, man. Because I ain't catching them. Somebody's got to come here and catch them. I'm sure everything is under that bridge too, but I can't do it. I can't. There's a bridge I can fish off of, but I can't do the video, the live stream. It's too many cars. It's too noisy. It doesn't work like that, you know. Well, right now, all that's probably on there is. Yeah, it's that method feeder that's on there, but, you know, I'm still 6-8 inches away with the corn. It's a shame, because I saw a couple roll when I got here this morning. Yeah, I hear you, Dan. I hear you, and I appreciate it, man. I appreciate everybody that comes in here and watches me. But it's a shame you can't catch fish, you know? It's not just, you know, the NJ hangout channel, you know what I'm saying? And I love that everybody comes here and hangs out, you know, talks amongst themselves. That's, you know, that's what it's all about. But you gotta catch some fish. Yeah, I hear you, Buggy. I hear you. I just can't believe how dead it is. Just completely dead. Yeah, Danny, I know. Well, you know what? I'm going to start taking a day off work every week, I think, or every other week, something like that, because I got to get out on the water at like 3 a.m. You know, coming out here at 10 o'clock and fishing right in the center of the day, it's not the ideal time, like you said, especially not in the summer, you know? Yeah, Billy, I know. But I wake up extremely early, so it's hard, you know, unless I have a day off. And I know that I know where there is a dam. You know, that's kind of where I fish at the lake too. I'm not too far from the dam that's on Pompton Lake. Tyler, it runs into a lake. It's technically a river, but it really doesn't run much. Honestly, it really doesn't run much. Really, Billy? I've never seen any of that. Yeah, I've never looked, but... I know a spot... actually, the dam is like 20 feet high. The only dam that I know about for this lake. Let's see. Bounce a rubber worm. I don't know. Those carp rods ain't doing jack. There are so many different flavors and scents and all sorts of stuff at the bakery. From vanilla to green apple to banana. Hey, that was just my rod. Quiet down, doggy. Let's throw a rooster tail on here and give this a couple casts. Can't hurt to try, right?
Over there.
crap day. crap carp.
I hear you, Seraphin. I hear you. It's annoying, man. Ugh. Believe me, I'll be back at it tomorrow. Yep, that's true.
Mangled mess.
The fish clearly aren't here. So I'm not going to go through any more misery. And I already have. So I'm going to pack these rods up. Yeah, I'm going to be back at it tomorrow. I'm going to the lake. Actually, I'm going to go to the lake now, and I'm going to throw some corn out and the rest of my pack bait. Try to lure them in. And then I'll go do the same thing tomorrow morning around 7. And then I'll go out fishing when I'm done work. It's the only thing I could do, but I had a largemouth bass on. I had a couple hits. I had it all on the spinnerbait. I would have landed the bass, but I was trying to force it in. Trying to force it up over the ledge instead of going down there and just lifting it. It wasn't big by any stretch of the means. It was a pound and a half, but
it's all right.
There's always tomorrow. There's always tomorrow. I appreciate everybody hanging out here. Hopefully tomorrow I can find some fish. The day has to come where I find fish. Again. Not that I haven't caught fish this year. Or, you know, since I've started my lives. But it's just, the fishing was good back in May. All of a sudden, it just started to die out. So I'm going to see if I can chum them over. No corn kernels on here. It's good. I knew I was going to peck that by something small. I'll go chum a bit over there. And I'll be back at it tomorrow again. Probably for 3 to 4 hours again. Obviously, whether there's fish or not. But all right. You just gotta, I guess, have a lot of patience when you're carp fishing. Something that I normally don't have, but I've learned to gain some patience while doing this. Believe me, because growing up, I was always a trout, bass fisherman, pickerel, stuff like that. I'm always bouncing around, casting, moving, walking up the shoreline. It was a whole new different style of fishing. You know, I figured if I'm going to do live streams and stuff like that, I can't be. It's hard to get to a spot where I can keep the camera, you know, in one area. And bass fish or trout fish or something like that. Because if I'm throwing lures, I'm walking up and down the shoreline. It's
tough. Even right here, I'm going to take 60 casts in the same 10 feet. You know? Doesn't work like that. Doesn't work like that. But for lives and, you know, stuff like this, it's easiest to go out and carp fish and catfish. But you ain't got to move. You ain't got to do nothing. You know, you're just hanging out in one area. I'll get on the fish eventually. I just got to find out what works in the summer for them. You know, today I went mostly just corn and you know, cornmeal. Honestly. I stayed away for the most part from the flavor of this, you know, strawberry and stuff like that. Did I use it in the beginning? Yes. But I mostly fished kind of just bland corn. So, I'll find the suckers. I'll find them. Some nice ones, hopefully. And I know there's big ones in Pompton Lake. In the 40s, at least. Because I've seen them caught. So I gotta go back there. That's where I'm gonna go right now. I'm gonna go chum over there. Throw out two cans. What's up, Pete? How you doing, buddy? All right, guys, I'm going to pack it up. Well, I did pack it up. I'm going to wrap it up. And I appreciate you guys coming in here. I'll be live again tomorrow. Just, you know, if you guys are bored or if you want to come hang out, it's up to you. I'm fishing the lake tomorrow. I'm done with this spot. The spot is not producing. But let me see. Let me start the car. Again, I appreciate you guys tuning in. Antifreeze, jeez. Oh, all right, guys, I'm gonna start the car and then I'm gonna come hit that end stream button, that red end button. Again, I appreciate you guys tuning in here. Feel free to hit that like button. I'm sure all of you guys are subscribed. I'll be back at it again tomorrow. I will be back at it, and I will find fish. There's times you want to give up, but I ain't giving up. That's like you guys are saying. That's what fishing's about. I've had dry runs. I just didn't do YouTube at the time. I've had plenty of dry runs in my life fishing. It just seems a little more aggravating when you're, you know, making videos of it. But all right, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it. I'll see you guys over somewhere else, another channel. You guys are awesome. Who's better than you? Right? Who's better than you guys? Nobody. Thanks, guys. I'll see you guys later. I'll see you on the flip side, guys.